Hi and welcome to Miss Ink's YouTube channel. My name is Emelie and I'm so excited to be a part of the Miss Ink video design team. And this week we are introducing all of the new designers, and every day we will bring you a new video and a new creator, and we will talk a little bit about our styles and what you can expect from all of our amazing videos that is coming your way. So for my video today, I wanted to go with everything that I love so I can introduce myself in a good way. And I love a simple and clean card. So that is what you will get today. And by the way, stay tuned to the end of this video because I will talk a little bit about all the amazing prizes that you can win over the week, this week. So stay tuned for that. I started out by creating a background, a rainbow background, because that is something I really love. And I use something that you probably have in your stash. This is just a combination of all the distress products that I have. It's some refills, it's the mini, and it's the big ink pads of the regular distress inks, if I didn't say that. So I am going back and forward creating a rainbow here, and this is something I learned during this process of creating. I will actually have two cards for today. That Arches watercolor paper has a little bit more texture, and that is the one I'm using here on screen, and this didn't warp a thing. So if you want to use a lot of water and don't adhere your paper down flat to anything, that is a good tip to go with a cardstock that have a little bit more texture. So the second card here, I want it to be a little bit more soft, but you can see really on the screen how it's warping. And it's the Canson XL watercolor paper. And yeah, I like it. I have had it in my stash for a long time, but it warped quite badly. So I just wanted to mention that if you were thinking of how to solve that, I will show you in the end how I did this. So here it is, this beautiful stamp set from Miss Inks, and I used a combination of my X-Acto knife, a scissor, and also my scanning cat to cut this out. You can just use an X-Acto knife or a scissor if you want to recreate this. So one of them I just cut out without coloring, and the other one you can see here on screen which colors I used. You can hit the pause button if you want to have a closer look. And I wanted to color this in with a really soft color combination. And I don't like orange. That is really weird when I'm saying it out loud, because orange is a really beautiful color, especially on the fall. But I am not a huge fan of it, so I went with a softer orange color combination here with a lot of brown in it. And I think that worked out perfectly for my flower arrangement here. Or let's face it, it's not flowers, it's more pumpkins, of course, but it's my take on a fall flower arrangement here. So I really love this stamp set. I think it was released last fall, but it's still a showstopper to me. And I used, as you can see on my leaves here, I'm starting to color them in now, a really soft combination for my leaves as well. I wanted it to be more of a bluish teal green combination than a like forest green, if that makes sense as well. And I will show you what colors I used. I showed you previously, but I can leave them linked down below if you want to as well. Oh, by the way, all the products I'm using, stamps and stuff like that, I will always leave down below so you can follow the link if you want to take a closer look at them. And here you can see I'm starting to get my arrangement colored in. And I really like how this is turning out. I am speeding this up quite much because I'm not this fast at coloring at all. But hey, what you do? You want you to keep the interest and not watch me color forever. So here you can see what I mean by the paper warping. So the one to the right is the XL and the other one is the Arches. So it worked quite badly. I will go in now and adhering this with some dimension. And you can see that soft coloring, it was really a good move, I think, to keep it that soft. So for the sentiment, I went with the beautiful thankful that also comes in this stamp set. And I just cut it out with my scanning cat and also use my X-Acto knife to go around all the inner parts. I tried to mix this up a little bit so they didn't look identical. And you can see one of the clusters here, I didn't color at all. So you can easily mass produce this. let's like take a big piece of paper and just watercoloring it in rainbow, and then you can cut it out to many cards at once and just use this uncolored clusters. I think that would be fabulous. But I took my time and raised it all up with some foam here, and I really like the dimension that that creates. And thankful I actually here flat down, so you get that nice play of dimension here. And you will see in a second, I will also embellish this a little bit with some sequins. These are from Trinity Stamps, and you can see the nice border as well. I put some double-sided foam adhesive as well on the backside of these, and you can see the nice white border, and that is what brings these basic cards together. I think it's the white space around. It really ties everything together and calms the cards down. So I hope you like that. So this week, since we are introducing the new video design team, we are having prizes. So make sure that you leave some comments down below, because every day one person will win a $25 gift certificate to the store and one grand prize, a winner of over $100 worth of gifts or products from the store. So make sure that you leave some love. And also, if you haven't seen the video from yesterday, make sure that you do that, and also come back tomorrow for even more inspiration. I am so happy that you spent some time here with me today. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and like this video. Until next time, have a great day. Bye!